How do we bend an offset in Conduit? All right, so when we're gonna do an offset, essentially what we want is we want the bend to kick up like this. Say that we have an obstacle like this box that we wanna clear. We have to bend a portion down this way, and then we have to bend another portion this way so it'll clear over that box. So let's actually do the distance for this. So the first thing you have to do is figure out what your actual offset's gonna be. So this is 2¼ inches that I'm trying to clear. So I have to bend a 2¼-inch offset. What that means is I need to double that number. I'm gonna do a 30-degree bend, and I just know that that means that that's a 2x multiplier. Every degree bend that you're gonna do, whether or not you choose to do a 45-degree bend, if you choose to do a 60-degree bend, or if you choose to do a 30-degree bend, they're all gonna have a little bit different multiplier. So check your Uglies manual. I keep one of those things on me every day because it just keeps all the multipliers and all this information in there. It's really handy. But I just know off the top of my head that a 30-degree bend is gonna be a 2x multiplier. So whatever your object is that you're trying to clear, you just take that measurement and multiply it by 2. So we just did 2¼. 2¼ times 2 is 4½. So we're gonna have a 4½ inches between our first bend and our second bend. And that's how we're gonna bend the offset. Let's do like 18 inches. So my first line I'm gonna draw at 18 inches. And then I know that my offset we said was 4½ inches, right? So we're gonna go 4½ and we're gonna draw our second line. So our first bend, we're gonna be bending up this way. And our second bend, we're gonna flip it over 180 degrees and bend up again. A lot of people mess offsets up because they forget to turn the conduit over. Another thing to do with your pencil, not with a marker, I'm just doing this with a marker so y'all can see it on video. But your first mark, you can just mark a regular mark. I always carry my second mark around the conduit because you're gonna end up bending one, you're gonna end up flipping the conduit and then bending the other one. So I always draw my second line around. Now, I wanna give a big shout out to Penn Aluminum. Thank you so much, Penn, for sending me all of this aluminum conduit and for sponsoring this video. So the benefits of working with aluminum conduit, A, it's way lighter, so like you wouldn't believe how much like a big stack of conduit that you can lift up when it's aluminum. It's so much lighter. A lot easier to bend too. So like if you're used to bending like 1¼ inch and a half conduit, being able to bend aluminum versus like really like struggling with steel. So the benefit, you know, is obviously it's lighter, but being able to bend it is such a huge thing. There's even this coating that they can put on the inside of the conduit that's called blue lightning. It's sort of like a Teflon coating, but it essentially makes pulling a lot easier on the inside of conduit. A lot of times when you're using aluminum conduit, it kind of catches more than the steel does. So it's a little bit more difficult to pull wire through sometimes, but with a coating like this, it comes through with a breeze. And the cost of aluminum versus the cost of steel, you're always gonna pay less with aluminum than you are with steel. So just kind of across the board, it makes sense to be using aluminum conduit. If you're interested in finding out more about Penn Aluminum or looking into their aluminum conduit, check the link in the description below. All right, so first bend, I'm gonna line up with my arrow, just like I was doing with a 90. Now I'm gonna look for the 30-degree line and I'm gonna bend this until this line is parallel with this conduit. It's not gonna be exact, you kinda have to figure out where that point is. There might be a little bit of a play or a little bit of a difference, so don't overbend and be all super gusto about it. Most of the time a bender, when this ends up straight up and down, and you can stick a level on it, most benders are set up for straight up and down to be a 30-degree bend, but not all benders. There are benders out there where straight up and down is actually 45 degrees, so just know what you've got. But here we go. Make sure that we press down while we're pulling back on the handle. That's the super, super important part a lot of people forget. If you don't, and you just start pulling back on this, you're gonna bend all the rest of this, so you're gonna have a bent piece of conduit a whole way down. So just step down and do more pushing down than you do pulling back. And also, since this is aluminum conduit, I don't want it to kink or I don't want to mess the pipe up. So if I'm not super tight and pushing down and keeping that, like riding really nice in the smoothness of that shoe, I'll end up messing it up. So I'm about level with the ground right now. Stick that on there. Still a little off. Let me go just a touch more. Anytime you're making adjustments when you're bending conduit too, you can step on this just a hair, bend just a little bit. Way less than you think actually translates to a lot down here. So when you make little adjustments like that, you can still see that I'm not in that bubble. So I'm gonna go a little bit more, just make a little tiny adjustment like that. And we're right in the middle there. Now, if you look down here at the bottom, I'm actually at 30 degrees. That 30 degree line is parallel with my conduit. So I know I just did a 30 degree bend. I know I'm taking a lot of time here, but for those of you that have never done this, I feel like it's a good idea to give you the extra explanations. Now, the next thing you can do is there's two options. You can try to flip this over and take your arrow and go to the next line, but look what happens. Now the pipe's in the way. Some of you that are like really good at conduit bending, you know there's a certain amount of pressure you can add and just bend down on this and pull it, but it's actually gonna end up rounding your bend more, so it's a sloppier way to do it. So the better way is to take this and set the conduit up like this. All right, so we need to make sure first and foremost that our line on the bender is still on the line. The second thing is you wanna make sure that this bender is straight on with that pipe. You don't want this thing kicked like that when you're trying to bend it, because that means it's gonna shoot off one way. So you need to try to line up your pipe. And sometimes it takes like sitting back here and looking at it. And if you don't do this right, well, you'll create what's called a dog leg. And it means it kind of kicks off, goes dog leg left or dog leg right. Maybe that's just a Texan thing that we say. So I think that looks pretty good. Now what I'm gonna do is I take my foot, don't put your foot back here, put your foot right here, and you're gonna kind of lean this bender forward a little bit and apply downward pressure. It's really important that you don't come back here and start bending, because you're actually gonna bend the conduit over here. Again, like every time that we bend and do anything with bending, we wanna stay as close to the bender as possible so that it keeps all of the pressure uniform in this shoe and it only makes the bending happen where we want it to bend. So I think this looks good. I'm gonna kinda lean my weight down and pull down on this right about here. Here we go. Little by little. All right, so the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try to line up my 30 degrees again so I know that my 30 degrees is parallel with that conduit. And to me, that looks good right there. And I'm gonna flip this thing back around, put it on the ground. And to me, that looks like where the box is gonna be. Sometimes if it's a little off, you might, you know, if it's like angled up slightly, rather than trying to re-go do all of that bending, a lot of times you can just take and push down in the middle and it'll pop that side up, which translates it going back down that way. So you can kind of work with the bends a little bit. Don't hammer on it or anything like that, but you can do little adjustments. So let's see what we got. That perfectly clears it. Maybe an eighth inch too high, but you can see too, it kind of slants up at the top. So what I was talking about is I know I want that side to go like that. So if I flip it over, that means I want that side going like that. If I push and just do a little bit of pushing, you can see that's better. It's getting slightly better. But you should do that a couple of times and get it adjusted where you want. But there you go. That is the offset. That is specifically a 30 degree offset. 45 degree offset's just gonna come up at an angle like this more. And a 60 degree is gonna come up like that. But you can kind of translate that when you're out there bending. Now, one thing to note with regular offsets is you have a few different angle options. So whenever you're bending, just make sure if you're bending 30 degree offsets and you're using that math, to do that on every single one when you're stacking a bunch of conduit together, that's the way that you're gonna get them all to look the same. If you do one of your offsets at 45 degree bends and the other one at 30 degree bends, they're gonna be offset and it's gonna look like crap. You can do 60 degree bends, a little bit crazier, but there's math. If you have an uglies book, just open your uglies book and it shows you what the multipliers are for each one. So I hope that helped. Thank you guys so much for watching. Love you crazy people. I'll see you in the next one.